for Williamson County, this is Week in Review.
In ESL, we made a snack from America called Ants Across the Log, and it was so fun to make it.
At Clovercrest Be Mindful Night, we learned different ways to help calm ourselves in stressful situations.
Today in art, we're making pinch pots.
Hi, my name is Trip Tatum, and first grade at Scales had business day today, and I sold lava lamps.
We did a texting while driving simulating.
There's a lot going on while like you're trying to text and like pay attention to driving. So like it was just a lot to do like at once. So it was very distracting from actually like driving.
This week we dissected a frog.
And we learned how the organs work together to maintain homeostasis.
We're here at Nolensville High School in English class. We're using soapstone to analyze Lyndon B. Johnson's speech on American policies in Vietnam.
Yesterday afternoon, we got to take on the 8th grade students on our annual hoop and holler game. And here at HMS, the teachers are still undefeated. Way to go, HMS.
Today at Ravenwood, we had our Make-A-Wish pep rally, and throughout the entire year, we've raised so much money so we can work with the Make-A-Wish Foundation to grant a kid's wish. And this year, we got to reveal to our little girl that she's going to Disney World.
Today in kindergarten, we were told the story of 3 billy goats gruff.
Who's that tripping over my bridge?
It is I.
The second Billy Goat.
This week in 6th grade social studies, we're learning about the Greek gods and goddesses.
Today was our Greek God or Goddess Day. We presented our final project.
The Nolensville Community Marathon is just around the corner.
Mill Creek reached a goal of 425 runners.
Mascots from Sunset Nolensville Elementary and High School and our very own Bolt had a dance-off.
This week at Independence High School in our Film 2 classes, we're working on our short films.
Hi, we're at Home Heritage Elementary, and today we are enjoying the book fair, and this is Dominic.
We've been buying books, having fun reading them, and we're having a great time.
Here at Grassland Elementary, we have been talking and reading the Volunteer State Book Award nominees for kindergarten through third grade. This week, kindergarten, along with first and second grade, are voting for the nominees that they like the best.
Today in choir, we played math games to count the beats of each note to remember them.
Today in STEM lab, we played with snap circuits, and we made a trombone.
This week, we've been working on Bring It On, the musical, and we've been working really hard on the rehearsals and performances, and tonight's the last night to see it, so come out at 7.
People have chosen things like skunks and sharks, but I chose chickens.
Each grade level recycles. We recycle paper, plastic, aluminum, and cardboard.
Today we're learning how to make a short film, and we're doing a parody to Small.
In science class today, we were discussing about natural selection. Instead of using animals, we used M&Ms to create what natural selection were. We were the predators and the M&Ms were the animals that we were hunting.
This week and every week at Trinity, we have been learning in classrooms and in our hallways.
Our small group has been discussing a booklet together with Ms. Sims and answering the questions.
In this class, we learned Python programming language. We start off doing text-based programs and text-based games, and then towards the end of the year, we start doing graphic programs.
We're learning about electrical circuits, and we're connecting circuits to a battery, and this is how it lights up.
At Lipscomb in PE, we're doing Latin dancing.
It has a nice rhythm, and it makes my heart beat.
Fine Arts Week is all about celebrating the things that we don't usually appreciate in life, like art, music, photography, theater, and it's just a way to bring together the school about something that we all like.
Today we're going to be visiting the Andrew Jackson Museum.
Hi, I'm Tess, and I'm in kindergarten, and we are practicing writing and reading our sight words.
This week at Fairview Middle School, we were instructed to design a project over the Aztecs.
This week, we've been raising money for the Boosterthon team to help raise money for our school. And today, we get to celebrate with the color run.
Today at Longview Elementary, we are playing a game called the Sock.
It's traditionally played with a ping pong paddle and a ball, but it's a little too hard for
fifth graders, so we are using a Walmart cage ball.
Okay, the project that we are doing in Ms. Griffith's class is a portrait with a background behind it.
This week at Renaissance High School, we had our Innovation Expo, where students showcased their year-long project to staff, parents, and other students.
We learned about dogs that help people,
and we have to train them a lot.
The fourth and fifth course is practicing for the Fine Arts Festival.
So let your heart sing, your heart beat, your confidence in your love.
Maya, third grader at Winston, and today we're doing a reader's theater play called Arachne and Athena, How Spiders Came to Be.
Fourth grade's gonna rock TCAP. We're practicing right now.
Students serve teachers from our Common Grounds coffee cart. Students learn valuable skills and adaptive behavior, as well as communication, while improving their independence.
We're just doing 1-point and 2-point perspectives on pieces of paper, where 1-point perspective is where there's one vanishing point, and then a 2-point perspective is when there's like two different vanishing points.
For the past 2 weeks at College Grove, we've been roller skating, falling down, and having a ton of fun.
This is Art 1 from Brentwood High School, and we're making prints.
At Jordan Elementary, second grade is having a Go Fish musical. It's about a tiger shark wanting some friends.
Today at Walnut Grove in third grade, it is chemistry day.
We're learning about chemical reactions, physical properties, mixtures, and solutions.
We made hypotheses and we followed up with experiments.
Today at Edmondson, we are learning about magnetic fields and how electricity flows through a cycle.
Thank you to our good news ambassadors and high school media teachers for submitting this week's fantastic footage.